Hey lads and lasses, Morten Åstad here. Welcome to my channel, and this is a reply to a community thread. So I am giving an answer to MGK Boston. I saw through a couple of other channels that he has done a challenge or a thread where we're supposed to spell out summer. Now, some of you have chosen a specific year. Some of you have chosen to just choose CDs or vinyl albums. I thought I'd choose a specific year, but then I came up short pretty much by one record. I didn't want to swap to CDs, and the record I was thinking about is not here. It's over in Denmark, and I'm in Oslo, Norway now. So what I chose was to do for myself the years 85 till 87, pretty important years of my life. I was turned 14, had my first summer girlfriend, made a lot of friends. 86, I remember, big upheaval in my life as far as you know, my parents and stuff. And me and my dad in 87 finally went to the US together, and that was pretty huge. You know, it was Florida, and that's where I saw, went to Disney stuff and Epcot and Key West. Oh, I remember I was in Fort Lauderdale. I even saw a film being you know, shot on the street there. You know, all that American, and I went to a minor league baseball game, which was, you know, pretty cool. In retrospect, I think it must have been spring training, because it was that time of year, and I never found that there were any permanent double A or single A, triple A teams around there. But it's, you know, I just thought it was so amazing that I sort of forgot who they were. Anyway, so I chose those 3 years. So let's start with the letter S. Some of these are the band names, and some of them are the name of the record. So the first one is Skritti Politti, with their, or his, amazing album Cupid and Psyche 85. I was going to go for something obvious, but let's say I'm pretty sure someone else is going to pick the Smiths. So that was the S. Then there's the letter U. Again, could have gone with something obvious, but I don't have any of their albums from that period in vinyl here. So we go for Ultravox, U-Vox, the final album with Mitch, wasn't it? Did they continue? Well, they have recorded since with him, yeah. So this one is from 1986. And was it a particularly good follow-up to their previous success, or was it more of a, you know, what happened to Yes after their big hit? Anyway, that's the U in summer. Next one. I have a box set, and I have a newer vinyl record of this one, but I chose to pick my original bought copy there, bought in Denmark in the summer of, well, it must have been 87, Master of Puppets. Metallica, Master of Puppets. That's the first M, and as you can see, this is the Music for Nations. This was bought in a stereo shop in Skagen in Denmark. The year it came out, and it blew my legs away. I had never heard anything like this before. Now the next record, and you think, oh, it's synth music and, you know, heavy metal. What's next? Well, I like most music, except rap. Pretty much. Well, I love the Beastie Boys, but anyway. Next one. Music for the masses. This is perhaps my personal favorite Depeche Mode album. This is when everything falls into place, even the look of the band with working with Anton Corbin in the videos. You can really hear that the orchestration from Alan Wilder is really, the work that he does with the whoever is producing after the other guys have left the recording studio. This is when Alan Wilder really, on this one and the next couple of albums, really moves Depeche Mode, not as a songwriter, but as, like I said, someone who orchestrates. And they never got back to these heights after he left. So I love this album so much. And that's the second M, In Summer. And then it was the letter E. I was thinking I was going to go for Echo and the Bunnymen, but again, I only have the CDs here. My vinyl records are in Denmark. So I went for Eat 'em and Smile, David Lee Roth. Oh, I listen to this a lot. And I listened to it on tape back then. This is a used record I got through Discogs a couple of years ago. I wore this tape out. This and the Skyscraper. Walking to school and stuff, I would listen to it all the time. So that was the E. So that's S U M M E. And the final one, well, difficult, but a band I listened to a lot in the 80s, and then since I've listened to a lot, it's a band that I put on when I want to relax and just hear good musicianship, and I love them, and it's a typical of my British American moving back and forward. These two countries are very important to me, obviously. And it's Level 42, Running in the Family. Their amazing biggest hit, not my favorite. World Machine is probably my favorite album from them. They're still playing. They haven't released a new album in a while now. Last one was come up on 15 years now, Retroglide. But, it's just music that I love to listen to at pretty much any given time. So, to MGK Boston, I got dressed up for you. Although, I love the Boston Red Sox. Some of you will notice that I wear Colorado Rockies stuff a lot, but just quickly, what introduced me to baseball living in Norway was the TV show Cheers. And Sam Malone was a washed-up Boston Red Sox pitcher who woke up from all his drinking one day, and all he had left in his life was this bar, Cheers, that he had bought at some stage. And I was a kid and I thought, what is a Boston Red Sox pitcher? What is any of that? What is baseball? And I found out, kind of through books, this was before internet, and Norwegians have no knowledge of baseball whatsoever. So that was the start of my lifelong passion for baseball. Later on in my life, I went to Colorado and Denver a lot, and I ended up being a Colorado Rockies fan. But I decided that since I live in Norway, I think, and being, an ambassador for baseball, I should be allowed to have a favorite American league and a favorite National League team. So that's my excuse. Sorry if that offends anyone. Anyway, thank you for watching this. Please respond in the comments. Please make up your own thread about summer. And I hope that you will join me in another video soon. Please click the like button and please click subscribe. And I will see you again in another video. Take care, guys. Bye.